Hello everyone, my name is Adèle Joyeux. I'm an earth science student and you are watching Poetry Channel. A poetry is something that shouldn't exist, but in some parts of Siberia they are growing. They are the physical manifestation of the changes we are facing now. This journey aims to take you to a journey to discover the fascinating and fragile beauty of the frozen world. When I was young, I was fascinated by minerals. And I don't know why, but I thought that geology was impossible for me. I went to an art school instead, and my artistic work is about a tree who is dreaming of traveling through the world. Now, as an adult, I've continuously felt a call. First, I took small actions in that direction, but suddenly I realized that purchasing my dream was not impossible at all. In that moment, that there was no obstacles anymore. So I did it, I went to the university, and now I'm a student, I'm an earth science student, and I use my real journey to draw the imaginary trip of the tree. I want to share this with you, I want you to come with me, I want you to meet Moustachu, the traveling tree. Moustachu is the name of the tree because of his moustache, and we are going to travel a lot on this channel, so come with me, come with us. Today we are going to Antarctica. Today on our trip to Antarctica we are going to Dumont-d'Urville, the French scientific station. It's located on an island that is 5 kilometers far from the Antarctica's coast, and it's near the South Pole. And the program 414 aimed to record the background noise of the sulfur compounds in the atmosphere. Every year there are people that are sent there to do the analysis for this program, but also for others. And I want to talk about this program in particular because, firstly, I think it's amazing, and secondly, this year I want to apply, I want to join the team. And there are people that go there for the summer mission, they stay 6 months, and there are a few people that stay for the winter mission and they stay 12 months. And I want to do the winter mission. What is interesting about that is that during the polar winter, the island is totally isolated. It's surrounded by sea ice, so there is no boat that can come, no helicopter, nothing at all. You are alone with the staff. And I think it's an extreme experience because of the environment that is extreme, it's Antarctica, but also because of the human experience that is also extreme, because you stay with the same people every day in it's almost like you live on a boat. So it's a very intense experience. It's amazing. I think I want to do that. No, Julie, there are no shops in Antarctica. It's only the station, there is nothing else there. No, Mom, I won't be able to call you every day, I'm so sorry. There is no Wi-Fi there. You can only speak with the scientific team about the machines and the problems and the analysis. And you are totally cut off. Everyone you know, your friends, your family, everyone. And you don't know what the world will look like when you come back. It's the hardest part of the project. It's a huge commitment. Yes, Chloe, the night lasts 3 months. It's incredible. The night lasts 3 months. And there are polar lights. Yes, that's the name, I think it's polar lights. You can see polar lights there during the polar winter. It's incredible, it's magic, I so want to see that. And by the way, I want to say a very huge thank you to Chloe, because she is my first ever subscriber to the channel, and she also helped me with the makeup. So thank you, Chloe. I hope I see you when I come back. As I said, it's a huge commitment. Why do I want to do this? Because I want to take part of a polar research program, and this one in particular is amazing, and here is why. The sulfur compounds play an essential role in the biological processes. Their emission sources come from the continental biosphere and also the marine biosphere, but they are also produced by humans with the burning of the fossil fuels. The sulfur cycle is complex. When I first saw it, I went in PLS for a few hours in the corner of my bedroom, I promise. But don't worry, I make it simple for you. As you can see, there are six boxes named réservoirs. The sulfur compounds are exchanged between the boxes through chemical reactions. And the sulfur compounds stay in each box an amount of time called residency time. For the atmosphere, it's a few days. I'm sorry if you hear my roommate. Remember, I'm a student. So, in the atmosphere, the sulfur compounds are mainly present in the form of aerosols. They play a key role in the nucleation of the clouds, and therefore in climate. They are also responsible for the acid rain, and this is a huge environmental and human problem. That's why we need to fully understand the behavior of the sulfur compounds in the atmosphere. In order to do that, the scientific team compares the actual data from now that are collected every year to the old one that are recorded in the ice core. The actual data are collected in Antarctica because it's far away from any human emission source. And as we said earlier, the residency time of the sulfur compounds in the atmosphere is just a few days, so they disappear before they arrive to Antarctica. So there is only the natural one. There are ones from the ocean and the one from the continent of Antarctica. And the scientific team study the wind and the meteorological information, and also other data, other elements, other molecules to identify the source. As you can guess, a marine source will be associated with different molecules than, for example, the penguin source. The molecules associated with the sulfur compounds will be different. So with the wind, with the molecules, we can know where the sulfur comes from. And then we can understand what is going on. As you can see, the scientific team is doing hard work. And I really want to help them with this video, but also on the field. I hope they seriously consider my application, and so I can make a new video with actual images that come from real Antarctica that I took for you. And it will be amazing, I think. And that's it for the video about Antarctica. Now I want to share something with you. I want to thank a lot someone, a researcher, one of my former teachers named Gilles Delegue. He helped me a lot through my first year at the university in Grenoble, and he gave me a very useful tip. And I want to share this tip with you. It's about how to find an internship. You may just look for what you are interested in the internet, and you search, and you find researchers that are working on that subject, and you just ask them to give you the opportunity to learn, because you are interested in the topic they are working on. Most of the time they say yes, they do. It's not every time, but it's the most of the time, so this tip was very useful for me. I hope it can help you in your study if you are a student, or I don't know. Yes, it was very useful for me to have an internship looking forward, helped me to go to class to learn very much better, and it helped me a lot. So thank you, Gilles, thank you a lot. Well, that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to learn more about earth science and cryosphere, come with me, subscribe. The next time we are going to Siberia. I will talk about an amazing project named Pleistocene Park, and I really, really hope you will be there for this. So thank you, and see you soon. Bye-bye.